Why are certain equity indexes and stocks more sensitive to what happens in the bond market than others? Part of the answer lies in the fixed income concept of duration. Duration is a metric that measures how long it will take to get the money that justifies the current valuation. Bonds with longer duration are much more interest rate sensitive than short-term securities. High coupon bonds of the same maturity as a zero coupon bond have a much lower duration, since much of the incoming cash comes as coupon payments. Many stock pickers do not think of equities in terms of their duration, but stocks are generally considered long duration assets. Moreover, high growth stocks can have exceptionally long durations as the growth rate compounds into the future and pushes the anticipated returns further out in time. By contrast, high dividend stocks, just like coupon paying bonds, have lower durations. Now, what does this mean for equity indexes? The tech-heavy, growth-intensive NASDAQ is a super long duration index, while the Dow Jones Industrial Average has a lower expected growth and pays higher dividends, so it has a much lower duration. The Russell 2000 is also a low duration index, as the expected cash flow from small cap stocks is likely to arrive sooner. No surprise then that as the yield on U.S. Treasury notes and bonds has risen sharply in 2021 with the increase in economic optimism and the massive fiscal stimulus package, the long duration NASDAQ has seen more volatility and has been challenged on a relative basis compared to the Dow or the Russell 2000. Duration is only part of the puzzle, but when bond yields are rising, it's an important factor to consider in evaluating the different returns among equity indexes. I'm Blue Putnam, Chief Economist, CME Group.